So this is the perimeter of the fire. This area has actually been contained in this area here. The H's represent hand line. So when we fight fire, you might see on the mainland where they use air tankers or big, what we call very large air tankers or VLATs, you know, like the DC-10s or other large aircraft. Aircraft doesn't put out fires. Aircraft, when they drop either water or fire retardant, they're literally slowing the speed of the fire to allow crews to get in here. So by being able to use those tactical water drops during the fire, so the helicopters that we were able to get for this fire, crews can get in there and construct that hand line. In this area, there's actually a hose lay, and so crews are actually working in this area today by cold trailing and looking at that hose lay. When they cold trail, they literally go hand over hand with the back of their hand to be able to check for any heat. And so it's a very slow, meticulous process. One of the things on this fire we were able to use was actually natural features and barriers like ah-ah flows here and here to be able to slow the progress of the fire.
So the purple is
these are the kipukas. Okay. Yeah, these are the kipukas. So this is kipuka key, and that was a huge asset that was at risk, that huge value. And so having that knowledge from the park and from others in the area and the community about the high value of this area, we really focused our efforts on it. One of the reasons why it's not showing as completed fire line, the black shows you areas that we've completed, is we want to be 100% sure before we actually make this red black. And so it's just a slow process. And
that's the 10% outstanding.
Yeah, it's this part, and then there's a little section within here.
Is there anything at risk on that top side?
So because the fire is contained, that risk is greatly reduced. What people are going to see from now and for a little bit longer is they're going to see interior pockets of stumps and other logs that are still burning. So what we're telling people, especially if the helo bound traffic on Highway 11, they're still going to see smokes as they drive down the road, but they're within the burn unit. We're not going to put firefighters into this area because there's no threat to the fire line. It's just not as safe. It's not, how do I say this, the
low value
assets. Yeah, exactly. The low values are there, you know, that it's not risk putting somebody's life for something when it's not going to compromise the fire line. But people will see these pockets as they burn down. So this is where we're looking at where the origin of the fire is. You know, this is an ongoing fire, so these maps do change. They do shift boundaries a little bit here and there. So this gives us a really good idea at that moment. It's a snapshot what the final map will look like that will be determined once the fire is completely declared out.